Hi guys, welcome back. We're going to be doing yoga for a fast metabolism. Let's begin a little differently today. At the top of our mat, in Tadasana, standing up nice and tall, pressing all four corners of the feet into the mat, igniting the legs by lifting the kneecaps, pelvis slightly tucked under, opening up through the ribs and the chest, shoulders relax. We're going to bring the hands to heart center. Close the eyes. We're going to take a few deep breaths, becoming present on the mat, doing our best to leave our stresses off of the mat during our practice. As we inhale through the nose, and as we exhale through the mouth, completely emptying the lungs. Let's begin. Deep breath in. And empty out those lungs. Breath in. Empty out those lungs. One more time. Empty out those lungs. Gently open your eyes. We're going to bring the right arm out and hook the left arm around as we pull it into our chest. You can keep a bend in the elbow or straighten it out if you like, depending on how much of a stretch you'd like. Look over that right shoulder. Take a deep breath here. And release. Left arm comes out. Right arm hooks around. We pull it in towards the chest. And look over the left shoulder. Take a deep breath. And release. Right ear comes towards the right shoulder. Keep that shoulder relaxed. Right hand gently rests on the head. Left arm comes out to the side. Take a deep breath. And this time, left ear comes to left shoulder. Gently rest the left hand on the head. Right arm comes out to the side. Take a deep breath here. Come back to neutral. Bring both hands out in front. We're going to grab the right fingertips and pull them under, stretching through the wrists. And then pull it over. Take it to the other side, left hand now, and over. Do a couple wrist rolls. And reverse. Hands come down by your side. Let's take some shoulder rolls. Just drawing some circles with the shoulders. Three one way, and three the other. Let's reach the arms overhead. Take an inhale here, and as we exhale, we're going to slowly open those arms up, twisting to the right side of the mat. You can turn and look back at that thumb if you'd like. And come on back. Big inhale, arms overhead. And exhale, open up to the left. Maybe you look back at that thumb. And come on back. We're going to reach the arms overhead. As we do, we look up towards the hands. Take an inhale, and we're going to exhale, slowly dive down. Coming in. your forward fold. Halfway lift. Take an inhale. And exhale back to forward fold. Hands come to the mat. We're going to step back to a plank. Hands come under the shoulders. We're pushing back through the heels. Pelvis slightly tucks under. And really make sure you're not sinking through that upper back. Round through that upper back. So you're really pressing through those hands. We're going to lift the right leg and hold for 3 breaths. If you need to modify, you can drop that knee down and then lift the right leg. Go ahead and replace that right foot. Let's take it to the other side. Lift the left leg. Take 3 breaths. And replace. From here, we're going to come right into our down dog. You may need to step it forward just a bit. Melting that chest towards the thighs. Tailbone reaching for the sky. Take a moment and bend one knee and straighten the other, stretching through the backs of the legs. Take 3 breaths here. Relax through the shoulders. Make sure they're not up against your ears. On your next inhale, right leg comes high to 3-legged dog. We're going to exhale. Bring that knee to right elbow. Come back to 3-legged as you inhale. Exhale, bring that knee over to the left elbow. Come back. 3-legged dog, inhale. Exhale, knee to nose. Round through that upper back. Come on back, deep breath in. And exhale, knee to chest. Step it between those hands. Drop down on that back knee. We're going to slowly begin to lift the arms overhead. Steeple grip. Sink into that front hip. Hold here for 3 breaths in your crescent lunge. Relax those shoulders. Gently release those hands. Frame the front foot. Curl the back toes. Slide that leg back. Coming back to your plank. Deep breath in, lift that right leg. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Replace that leg. Now to modify this, you would drop that knee down and then lift the leg. Okay, so let's take it to the other side. Inhale, lift the left leg. And exhale. Inhale and exhale. One more time. Replace that foot. Come on into your down dog. Take 3 breaths. Walk your dog. On your next breath in, left leg comes high, 3-legged dog. We're going to exhale, knee to left elbow. Inhale, back to 3-legged. Exhale, knee to right elbow. Inhale, back to 3-legged. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale, back to 3-legged. Exhale, knee to chest, step in between those hands, drop it down on that back leg. Squeeze those inner thighs to lift. Arms reach over the head. Steeple grip, just the pointer fingers are out, everything else is interlaced. Sink into that front hip and take your 3 breaths. moment. Take a few breaths. Come on back to a tabletop. Curl the toes. Back to down dog. From here, feet are hip-width distance. We're gonna grab for the right ankle with the left hand, and then peek under that armpit. Take a deep breath. And replace that hand. Let's take it to the other side. Right hand grabs for the left ankle, look under that armpit. Take a deep breath. And replace that hand. On your next breath in, right leg comes high, three-legged dog. We're gonna inhale and then exhale, knee to right elbow. Inhale, three-legged. Exhale, left elbow. Inhale, back to three-legged. Exhale, knee to nose. Come on back up, three-legged. Exhale, give yourself some height, step in between those hands. Stay lifted on that back leg. Squeeze the inner thighs to lift. Sink into it, push back with the back heel. Hands to heart. Bring that left elbow on the outside of that right thigh. Engage that core, lifting it off of that thigh. And take three breaths. Open up those arms. Take three breaths. Hands come back. Frame the front foot. Slide that leg back. Coming into your high plank. We're going to take a vinyasa here. So drop the knees if you need assistance. We're going to inhale, come forward on the toes. Exhale, elbows in at your side. Open up. Make sure you're not sinking in the shoulders. Lift up. Big inhale. And exhale right into your down dog. Take your three breaths. Next breath in, left leg comes high, three-legged dog. We're going to exhale, left elbow. Inhale, three-legged. Exhale, right elbow. Inhale, three-legged. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale, three-legged. Exhale, give yourself some height, step it between those hands. Stay lifted on that back leg. Squeeze the inner thighs to lift. Sink into it. Push back with that back heel. Hands to heart. Bring the outside of that right elbow to the outside of that left thigh. Lift that belly off that thigh. Take three breaths. Open up those arms. Three breaths. Frame that front foot. Slide it back. Drop the knees. Sit back on those heels. Use your elbows if you are still working on your child's pose. Use your block to rest your forehead on, and you can wrap your arms around your legs or forehead to the mat. Take three breaths. And let's lock those fingertips back up. Come into your tabletop, curl.
left foot behind the left hand. Toes are at the edge of the mat. Feet are slightly turned out. We're going to sink that tailbone towards the mat. Pushing those thighs out with your elbows, hands at heart center. Coming into yogic squat. Take an inhale. And an exhale. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. We're going to grab the right ankle, twist open, right arm to the sky. And switch. Grab the left ankle, left arm opens to the sky. Fingertips come to the mat. Straighten those legs. Toe, heel, back into hip width distance. Melting the belly down, coming into your forward fold. Grabbing opposite elbows. Ragdoll side to side. Swaying back and forth. And gently begin to roll up, one vertebrae at a time. Big inhale. Look up towards those hands. And exhale. Hands to heart. Let's heel toe those feet all the way together. Or knees come together first. That's fine. We're going to begin to bend through the knees. The belly is going to melt on top of the thighs. Arms can lift up towards the sky. Big inhale as we begin to lift those arms up towards the sky. And exhale, sink into your chair pose. Bringing more weight into the heels. You should be able to lift your toes. Open up through the chest. Big inhale, hands to heart. Exhale, bring that elbow to the outside of the right thigh. Lift that belly off the thighs, engage through the core. Take three breaths. Make sure those knees stay in line. Open up those arms. Take three breaths. Come back to heart center. Fingertips to the floor. Come back to forward fold. Big inhale. Big inhale. And slowly roll it up. One vertebra at a time, head comes up last. Inhale, reach the arms over the head, look up towards those hands. And exhale, hands to heart. Again, we're gonna start bending the knees, melting the belly to the thighs. Lift those arms up to the sky. Big inhale. Exhale into your chair pose. Sink back. Hands to heart. Twist over to the left. Keep those knees in line. Take three breaths. Open up those arms. Take three breaths. Back through center, fingertips to the mat, back to forward fold. Take a deep breath. One more deep breath. Slowly roll it up. As you lift the head, arms come over. Look up towards the hands. Exhale, dive right down. Come into halfway lift. Big inhale, and exhale, forward fold. Hands to the mat, step back. We're gonna come into a side plank. So here are some options. You can bring the bottom leg down and open it up, or you can bring the side of that bottom foot to the mat and then use the top leg as a kickstand and open it up. Or if you feel comfortable to stack both feet and then open up, we're gonna inhale and exhale, thread the needle 3 times. And come back to a high plank. Take it to the other side. Use whatever modification you need. Big inhale, exhale, thread the needle. Big inhale, and exhale, one more. Come on back, high plank, drop your knees down. Swing those legs around. Come on into a seat. Both legs out in front. We're gonna bring the left foot and place it flat on the mat, coming over that right leg. You can keep that leg out long or bend that knee, bring that foot in towards your glute. Both sits bones are on the mat. This foot is flat on the mat. From here, we're gonna take our right arm and place the outside of the elbow on the outside of that bent knee, straightening up through the spine, looking over the left shoulder. Hold for 3 breaths. And unravel. Let's take it to the other side. Right leg comes over that left. Foot flat on the mat. Again, that leg can stay out long, or you can bend that knee and bring that foot in towards the glute. Make sure both sits bones are on the mat and that right foot is flat on the mat. The outside of the left elbow comes on the outside of that bent knee. Fingertips come behind, straight spine, look over that shoulder. 3 deep breaths.
Hug it in.
We're going to hold it for 2 breaths. Deep breath in. Stretch it out. 1 more breath. Hug it in. Give yourself a little back massage. Rock back and forth. Feet flat on the mat. Hands behind the head. Open up those elbows. Lift that chin away from the chest. Look up towards the sky. We're going to lift the shins parallel with the sky. And we're going to bring knee to elbow on opposite sides. As we breathe. Once you've taken your 3 breaths, and if you do have a block, lift up on the ball of the feet, remove the block, unshimmy through the shoulders, and come down 1 vertebrae at a time. Now we're going to do plow pose. A good modification for plow pose, if you're still working on it, is by doing it right in front of your couch. So your head would be kind of close to where your couch is. And when you place your hands down by your side, lift the legs up to legs on a wall. And you push off, coming up and then over, you can rest your feet on the couch. And then work on getting that spine straight. Work on getting on top of those shoulders. You can interlace the fingers and make sure that neck is nice and long and open. And make sure you're breathing, of course. Let's hold this for 3 breaths. And let's bring our hands to the small of our back and see if you can lift one leg and then maybe the other. If not, you can just try one leg at a time, coming into a shoulder stand. Make sure the spine is straight, neck is open again. Now to come out of it, place 1 foot back on the ground or the couch, then the other, coming back into plow. Hands come down by the sides. We're going to slowly unravel 1 vertebrae at a time, using those hands as brakes to slow your roll. You do not want to come out of this quickly. Slow, 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 slow. When your tailbone hits the mat, hug the knees into the chest.
Bring nose towards your knees to counterbalance the spine or counteract. I always say counterbalance because it does work, but you know what I mean. And gently release. Let's take a nice, good morning stretch. Stretching out that core, stretching out that back. Bring both knees over to the right. You can bring the right hand on top of that left thigh. Maybe you look over to that left hand. And let's hold it here for three breaths. Come on back through center. Over to the left. Right arm comes out. That left hand can come on top of that left knee. Just make sure you're not like ripping yourself down, like pushing down. Just rest it. And make sure both shoulder blades are on the mat. Take three breaths. And come on back. Let's all slowly roll to one side in fetal position. Take that bottom arm and make it a pillow. That left hand can rest in front. And let's hold it here just for a few breaths, relaxing our body and cooling down. As comfortable as this is, let's come on up into a nice seat. You can use your trusty block to sit up on. I'm sure you all know this by now. I think most of you are return yogis who do my yoga often, but I do get some new people from time to time, so that's why I repeat myself often. I know most of you don't mind. All right, crisscross applesauce or half lotus. Sitting up nice and tall, relax through the shoulders. As we reach the arms overhead and take a deep inhale, I want you to picture love, positivity, prosperity, happiness. We're going to hold the breath at the top, and then as you release the breath, I want you to picture anything not serving you leaving with each exhale. We're going to do that two times. Let's begin. Deep breath in, reach those arms up. Look up and hold. Exhale. Let's reach those arms overhead one more time. Deep breath in. Hold it at the top. And let go. Hands to heart. Yesterday we did Kundalini breathing, which is actually very good for the digestive system. If you want to turn off the video here, feel free. If you want to do a couple moments of Kundalini breathing with me, you can stay. So, we're going to place our hands on our belly. We're going to take a big inhale. And as we exhale, we push out through the belly button. Until the breath is empty. Now, you can either exhale with the mouth closed or open, that's up to you. Let's do it one more time, deep breath in. Feeling the belly push out with each inhale. And begin. Practicing with me today. I hope I left you feeling nice and yoga stoned. I know I certainly am, and hopefully your metabolism is super fast. If not already, it will be soon if you keep doing yoga. I know my metabolism is faster than it's ever been in my entire life, and I attribute that to yoga. So anyway, have a great rest of your day. I will see you for tomorrow's practice, hopefully. Namaste. Thank you, guys.